Good morning. Oh. Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome. Welcome. For those of you who know me, would understand that reading from the script is probably something that I'm not too accustomed to. But be that as it may, I am here. You are here, and we are going to get the show on the road. Esteemed panelists whose guidance and expertise will lead us in our journey today. Guests of honors whose continued support and input have helped us to facilitate this process. Our audience who are the most important among us. For as the citizenry, it is through you that the fruits of today's labor be dispersed throughout our community. Good morning and welcome to our dialogue on mental health in Trinidad and Tobago, overcoming the stigma. While we understand the importance of Mental Health Awareness Month, Mental Health Awareness Week, Mental Health Awareness Day, we are of the strong belief that mental health awareness should not be relegated to a month, a week, a day, but rather should be everyday occurrence, more so since our people living with mental illness cannot wait for a month, a week, or a day. According to the United Nations Report on Mental Health, persons with mental and psychosocial disability represent a significant portion of the world's population. Millions of people worldwide have mental health conditions, and an estimated 1 in 4 people globally will experience mental health conditions in their lifetime. Almost 1 million people die due to suicide every year, and it is the third leading cause of death among young people. Depression is the leading cause of years lost due to disability worldwide. Mental health problems, including alcohol abuse, are among the 10 leading causes of disability in both developed and developing countries. In particular, depression is ranked third in the global burden of disease and is projected to rank first in 2030. This venture, ladies and gentlemen, has its origin through the Center for Human Development Limited and the Psychiatric Unit for Faculty of Medical Sciences through the collaboration with Professor Gerald Hutchinson. Through our conversation, we discovered a mutual recognition of the society's need as it relates to mental health awareness. We also found that people were also in need of greater knowledge surrounding mental health. For our society is in crisis, and if we do not realize this, we would not be able to save our children's children, and ourselves. Crime, the foremost symptom of this crisis, has numbed us with fear as we lock ourselves in our homes while our communities, our schools, our families continue to live in crisis. Within the psychological community, we have seen how little the cohesiveness is. Our paranoia of the other, leaving us isolated and distant. Within the school, the anger and the frustration of students are evident. Our teachers remain overwhelmed, and the link with the home disconnected. Within our home, the issue of mental health is seldom discussed. The parent-child relation has also been eroding, resulting in rudderless charges that are consequently misunderstood because we as adults have not taken the time to listen. Far too long, anger, frustration, disillusion, shame, and guilt have been the term underlining the meaning of mental health within our country. That has remained unchallenged in any cohesive way thus far. For we have seen the behaviors, and we may not be able to put a name to it. But within our shame, guilt, and disregard, we have ignored the issue. Worse still, we have developed a stigma around mental health within this country. A stigma that has misguided and false comfort in our mind. Professor Gerald Hutchinson pontificates, while the burden of stigma falls on those with mental health, by attitude of a wider society. He first stated, a world without prejudice, mindless discrimination, and feeling of superiority is fundamental for the development of the mind. Development that will be open and even mindful and joyful. Development that will truly embody the best of being human. Professor Hutchinson. It is noteworthy that in the past years, the infrastructure in our beloved country have been and continues to develop at a rapid pace, no doubt. Notwithstanding that, however, the United Nations Department of Economic and Social Affairs World Health Organization policy analysis, in its further analysis of the Millennium Development Goals, indicated that mental health must be seen as an emerging development issue, in so much as, ladies and gentlemen, as a paper has been written entitled Mental Health and Development, Integrating Mental Health into All Development Efforts. They went on to add that there are growing recognition within the international community that mental health is one of the most neglected yet essential development issue in achieving the Millennium Development Goals. Mental health represents a critical indicator of human development, serves as a key determinant of well-being, quality of life, and hope, has an impact on a range of development outcomes, and is basis for social stability. They continued as they brought the point home in looking at the vulnerability of persons with mental and psychosocial disabilities. They indicated that persons with mental and psychosocial disabilities often face stigma and discrimination due to a widely held misconception about the cause and the nature of mental health condition. Persons with mental and psychosocial disabilities also experience levels of physical and sexual abuse. This can occur in a range of settings, including prisons, hospitals, and homes. They encounter restriction in the exercise of socio-political and economic rights in the majority of countries, largely due to the false assumption that they are not able to carry out their responsibilities, manage their own affairs, and make decisions about their lives. So let us not skirt on the topic today and its implications for society. Mental health represents one of the most critical and serious challenges facing our country today. Our economic stability, social fabric, and family life depends on it, and it is central to this nation in crisis. Our journey today entails firstly breaking down this barrier of misunderstanding, as we shall do this by examining every facet of society and its relationship with mental health. When we speak of mental health today, ladies and gentlemen, we speak not only of the well-being and the wellness of the mind, but transcend our individual space to reach out to fellow man, woman, and child in a sense of community and family. The dialogue's purpose, therefore, firstly involves our critical input, both how you receive the information and how you relay this information to those around you. We come together to share this knowledge in a respectful manner, where all are acknowledged within this forum, regardless of age, gender, religion, ethnicity, or viewpoint. We are here to pool our ideas, thoughts, and respective expertise towards making a positive impact on this country. It is our hope that today you will be ambassadors of positive change, as you will be better informed in your decision-making as it surrounds issues of mental health. Such a responsibility many seem psychologically burdensome, with your own life and background, and you have to go back to today. But we implore you to utilize this dialogue to listen, to learn, to contribute to this learning. It is only when you have opened up yourself to possibilities, when you can truly appreciate the knowledge, what knowledge can do. And it is what lies in the core of today's venture. Awareness. the more aware we are, the more we are able to implement changes. To achieve this purpose, therefore, we have brought our esteemed panelists from some of the critical dimensions of the society to speak from their knowledgeable perspective and their area and its relationship with mental health. This is because the approach to the issue of mental health cannot be one-dimensional. In furtherance to which, we must be aware that mental health is also connected in every aspect of society. It is with these points in mind that we highlight each area covered today. The role you play, ladies and gentlemen, today is to engage our panelists by critically analyzing the information presented, asking questions. As we say in the classroom, no question is useless. What is useless is not asking the question. Too often we sit meekly by, and sometimes those who try to change or foster change are consumed with dissenting voices. The Center for Human Development and the single entities cannot do it alone. We come together idealistically, as it may sound, to support each other, because it is only through this collective effort that we can bring about change. Our major priority at the Center for Human Development Limited remains strengthening our families, building our communities, and developing our minds. Only through this synergistic approach can we move forward as a people. So we ask that you celebrate yourselves. You have made a tremendous and honorable effort by putting aside your busy life to commit yourself to this process. And ladies and gentlemen, for that, we thank you. And I thank you for being here personally. This means a lot. So I want you to celebrate yourselves. So celebrate yourselves. And I thank you, and God bless us.